So you want to do a bee removal. This is Charlie Agar with Charlie Bee Company. I've been doing bee removals for a number of years. I want to walk you through a way to make your own homemade canister bee vacuum. First, these are the supplies you'll need. You'll need a 5-gallon plastic bucket with a lid, a 2-foot length of 1¼-inch PVC pipe, 2 1¼-inch PVC couplers, a 1¼-inch ball valve. You'll need a small piece of thin plywood, about 1/8 of an inch, which you're going to cut into 2 9-inch diameter discs. So it needs to be at least 18 inches long, 9 inches wide. You'll need another piece of thick plywood, about 3/4 inches does the trick, enough to cut another 9-inch diameter disc. You'll need 4 1-inch by 1-inch pieces of wood, each about 12 inches long. You'll need a roll of No. 8 hardware cloth, very useful for beekeepers anyway, so get you some hardware cloth. You'll need Gorilla Glue and Gorilla Tape. You'll need some drywall screws, a roll of masking tape, and PVC cement. Here are the tools you'll need: safety glasses, a measuring tape, a pencil or a marking pen, a reticulating saw, a drill and a screw gun, hole saw bits. You'll need a 2-inch and a 1¾-inch diameter. You'll need a jigsaw, a staple gun, and a table vise if you've got one. So let's build our vacuum. First, you need a vacuum source. Any vacuum will do. I like a Home Depot bucket head or a cordless shop vac. Both have a suction tube with a 1¼-inch diameter. Whatever vacuum you choose, the size of the suction tube will dictate the size of the PVC entering your canister. Drill 2 2-inch holes on opposing sides toward the bottom of the 5-gallon bucket. Wrap a bit of Gorilla Tape around both 1¼-inch PVC couplers to ensure a snug fit and insert them into opposing sides of the bucket, with less than 1/8 of an inch of the PVC extending inside the bucket. You need to be sure to make room for the wire container. Seal the connection with Gorilla Glue and let it dry. While you're waiting for the silicone to dry, you'll make the wire basket. Cut 2 9-inch diameter discs from your 1/8-inch plywood and 1 9-inch diameter disc out of your 3/4-inch plywood. Scribe a circle about 1 inch toward the middle of the thicker 3/4-inch disc. Secure it in a vise and then cut out the middle of the disc with a reticulating saw to make it into a ring. This is the opening of your bee basket. Measure and cut your 1 by 1 inch pieces of wood to about 12 inch lengths and use them to secure one of the plywood discs and the 3/4-inch plywood ring. This makes your container. Once assembled, you'll wrap the container in No. 8 hardware cloth and staple it in place. Cut the hardware cloth to fit and staple it all tight. Now you've got your bee basket. Cut a 1¾-inch hole in the top of the container. This is where the bees will be pulled in. Cut about a 5-inch length of the 1¼-inch PVC. Wrap one end of the PVC with a bit of Gorilla Tape to ensure a tight fit and insert it into the top of the canister with about 1 inch of PVC inside the canister. Cement it into place with Gorilla Glue. Let it dry. While you're waiting for the canister to dry, return to your bucket. Cut 2 3-inch lengths of 1¼-inch PVC and use PVC cement to attach them to your couplers. Both of them should be dry by now. Attach the 1¼-inch ball valve to one of the PVC sections. This is how you reduce suction in the vacuum. Now back to the canister. The second 1/8-inch plywood disc is how you secure your wire canister. If you're crafty, you could attach it with a hinge or clasps, as you'll be opening it to release the bees. I prefer just using masking tape to hold it in place and removing the tape to release the bees. Once secured, insert your bee basket into the bucket. Cut a 1¾-inch hole in the center of your bucket lid and secure it in place on top of your bee vac. Attach your 1¼-inch hose to the top. You might need to put a little tape on it so it fits securely. This is the hose that will capture the bees. Attach your vacuum source hose to the PVC side of the bucket.
So now you're in business with your own bee vac. Right over here is your valve to reduce the amount of suction so you don't hurt any bees. You're going to pull bees into this chamber. And then when you're finished, you can take this off. Take this off. lift it out, take the bottom off, and dump your piece. You're a bee removal dude now.